How's everyone doing?
Well, if you're ready to rock and roll, I need to see your best rock and roll face on the count of three.
Here we go. One, two, three, rock and roll face!
Nice job, you guys! Well, welcome to Garage Rock / Emo Week here at Kid Row. And before we get started, you guys know the drill by now, we need to take a quick rock and roll call. So, when I call your name, I need to see your fist go up in the air and I need you to say, backflips! Alright, ready to give that a try? All together on three? Here we go! One, two, three, backflips! Nice job, you guys! So remember, open up your ears and listen for your name. Can we hear it from Max? Hi, Max! Up next, we have Michelangelo! Hi, Michelangelo! Up next, we have Mila! Hi, Mila! Now, can we hear it from Otis? Hi, Otis! Up next, we have Rain! Hi, Rain! Now, can we hear it from Riley? Hi, Riley! Last, but certainly not least, let's give it up for Tuesday! Hi, Tuesday! Nice job, you guys! Well, now that we know that everyone is here, let's get to rockin' and rollin'.
Hey, Kid Rowers! Are you ready to play a game? Oh, thanks! I love my hair, too. Alright, so we're gonna play Hey Johnny Walker as a freeze dance. So at the end when I say, do your thing and stop, you're gonna do your thing and stop. The first thing you're gonna do is stick out your tongue like, so do your thing and stop. Okay, you ready? Let's do it. Hey Johnny Walker, walking down the street, didn't know what to do, so he stopped in front of me and said, hey boy, do your thing, do your thing. Hey boy, do your thing and stop. Very good. Now, for the next gesture, for this freeze, I want you to do like buck teeth, right? Like, do your thing and stop. Can you guys practice that? One, two, three. Good. You guys look so silly. I love it. All right, ready? Little Johnny Walker walking down the street, didn't know what to do, so he stopped in front of me and said, hey boy, do your thing, do your thing. Hey boy, do your thing and stop. Very good. Those are like rabbit buck teeth. I love it. All right, this time I want you to make your best rock and roll face ever in the world. You got to practice it first. Ready? I'm going to do mine and you do yours on three. One, two, three. How about another one? Good. All right, you ready? Little Sally Walker walking down the street, didn't know what to do, so she stopped in front of me and said, hey girl, do your thing, do your thing. Hey girl, do your thing and stop. I can't do it with a pick in my hand. There we go. Now I drop my pick. Oh. All right. For the last one, I want you to do a spin and then your best rock and roll face. Can you guys do that? I bet you can. All right, you ready? Little Johnny Walker walking down the street, didn't know what to do, so he stopped in front of me and said, hey boy, do your thing, do your thing. Hey boy, do your thing and stop. Whoa, rock and rollers in the house. Good job, guys. Hope you had fun doing the Johnny Walker freeze dance. Peace.
Hey, backflips, who's ready for a little hey lolly? Awesome, let's hit it. One, two. One, two, three, four. Hey, lolly, lolly, lolly. Hey, lolly, lolly, oh. Hey, lolly, lolly, lolly. Hey, lolly, lolly, oh. This is a silly kind of song. Hey, lolly, lolly, oh. You make it up as you go along. Hey, lolly, lolly, oh. Hey, Max, Max, Max. Hey, Max, Max, oh. Hey, Max, Max, Max. Hey, Max, Max, oh. Hey, Michelangelo, Michelangelo, Michelangelo. Michelangelo. Hey Michelangelo, Angelo, Angelo. Hey Michelangelo. Hey Mila, Mila, Mila. Hey Mila, Mila, oh. Hey Mila, Mila, Mila. Hey Mila, Mila, oh. Hey Otis, Otis, Otis. Hey Otis, Otis, oh. Hey Otis, Otis, Otis. Hey Otis, Otis, oh. Hey rain, rain, rain. Hey rain, rain, oh. Hey rain, rain, rain. Hey rain, oh. Hey Riley, Riley, Riley. Hey Riley, Riley, oh. Hey Riley, Riley, Riley. Hey Riley, Riley, oh. Hey Tuesday, Tuesday, Tuesday. Hey Tuesday, Tuesday, oh. Hey Tuesday, Tuesday, Tuesday. Hey Tuesday, Tuesday, oh. Hey Lolly, Lolly, Lolly. Hey Lolly, Lolly, oh. Hey Lolly, Lolly, Lolly. Hey Lolly, Lolly, oh. Awesome! Good job, guys!
Hey, Kid Rowerooskies! It's time for a little brief recap on what we learned a couple weeks back, which is dynamics. I'll give you a hint what dynamics is. Dynamics! Yeah, it's when you start off really soft and then you get loud. So let's try a dynamic of I love Neil's pink hair. Ready? I love Neil's pink hair! Pink hair! Don't care! All right, team, let's do a little brief recap on stage presence. Stage presence is the way you present yourself on stage. So if you're kind of like this, then that's how you're presenting yourself. That's not very good stage presence, but if you're like, yeah, I'm here, I'm gonna sing, I'm gonna play the instruments, that's great stage presence. So, for example, if you're singing, you're using the microphone a little bit close to your mouth, like about that far apart, and you're singing directly into the mic. You can look at the audience and you can raise your hand up. You can do whatever you want, but you're moving and having fun. Fun, fun, fun. If you're playing guitar, you're rocking out, having a blast, bass, drums, you're crashing, you're going nuts, you're having fun. You guys can make lots of rock and roll faces like, grr, and or you could just be smiling and having a good time. The way we present ourselves on stage is stage presence, and we want great stage presence, which means we need to have tons of fun with our friends on stage. All right, good job, team. Here's another recap for you. Let's talk about tempo. Does anyone remember what tempo is? Right, it's the speed of the song. So the beat and the rhythm is going like, and that's the tempo, that speed. Now this is a different tempo. And this is a different tempo. So the drummer is always gonna count you in with the tempo when they're saying one and two and three, or they're gonna be like one, two, three, four. That's how you'll know what tempo you're playing in. Okay, let's do a little recap on song form. Song form is the way the song is laid out. So you start off usually in a song with an intro, which is the introduction of the song, which is usually some music or something. Then you go into the verse, which tells the story. Then you go to the chorus, which repeats itself and is the catchiest, hookiest part of the song usually. And then you go to another verse, another chorus. And eventually you get to a bridge, which bridges you from one part of the song to the next, to the end. And then you have either the last verse or the last chorus or whatever, however the song ends. Song form is the different parts of a song. Okay, little rockers, here's the deal. We are gonna now talk about a vocab word. So this week's vocab word is genre. And genre sounds French, but it's not, I don't think. But anyway, genre is like the different categories that music is in. So some songs kind of fit in more than one category, but a lot of times each category, each section, each group has a certain sound and a certain quality to it that makes it that particular thing. For example, country music sounds different than rap music. They're two different genres. One is country and one is rap, and they don't really sound the same. Now, once in a while, a country artist might use some rap, or a rap artist might use some country, but typically they're pretty separate and they're in their own category. Other categories or genres are rock and roll, pop, folk, R&B, jazz, just to name a few. Well, five in particular. Can you guys say genre? Ooh, oui, oui, you do sound French. Good job, guys.
Sing with me. All right, band. It's 2000s week here. We got the White Stripes, Seven Nation Army, one of the ultimate riffs of all time. Sing along and play along. Here we go. One.
Thank you. today, class, we are going to have a music history lesson.
So today's music history lesson is all about garage rock and emo bands. So garage rock was when basic chord patterns would happen in songs and the bands would kind of come together and they would traditionally play out of their garage. It was usually a bunch of friends after school, get together, go in someone's garage and pick up their instruments and start playing songs and making up songs together. And those were kind of how garage rock started. And some examples of garage rock are the White Stripes, the Strokes, the Black Keys, and the Yeah Yeah Yeahs. Now for emo, emo rock was, the word emo comes from emotion or emotional. So the lyrics of the song had a very emotional, confessional kind of thing where people were talking about their feelings in their songs. And that kind of happened in mostly in the early 2000s. Emo became a thing. This wig is a little bit emo. Not that it's a wig, it's my real hair. Let's be honest. People, when they dressed emo, the boys wore a lot of eyeliner and had their hair down in their face a little bit and kind of like wore jackets like this. And that was just kind of the look and that was what people did. Some emo bands that you might have heard of is Panic at the Disco or Good Charlotte or Jimmy Eat World, which you might be hearing a little more from today. I'm just having a feeling. And that's your music history lesson for today.
Band up on your feet, it's time to sing and dance. Repeat after me. It just takes some time. It'll go and then I'll have the ride. Everything will be just fine. Everything will be alright. Hit a chat of banana.
Recap of the Cute score. Awesome. So let's go over the notes that we are dealing with. We are dealing with A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. And then we go right back around to A and start all over. Go to right in the middle of the keyboard, find the pair of two black notes right in front of me, and then we step down one, we find our middle C. Can we all say that? Middle C. Awesome, good job. Our middle C, if we walk up 8 steps, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, we find C again. That is called an octave. Can we say that together? Octave. Awesome. An octave is 8 notes. Awesome. So from C to C is an octave. That's awesome. Keep on rocking, guys.
All right, you guys. Now we're gonna do a quick recap of the guitar. Now, one more time. How many strings does a guitar have?
Does it have 10,100?
Nah. Does it have 20,098? No. It's got, let's count it together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 strings. Now, each string has its own name, depending on what note they play. And those names are E, A, D, G, B, and E. And here at Kid Row, we have a way of remembering those names. And that is Eddie, 8, Dynamite, Good, Bye, Eddie. All right, so can we say that all together? Here we go. Eddie, 8, Dynamite, Good, Bye, Eddie. Good job, you guys. Now, does anyone remember what these little sections here are called? It's okay if you don't remember it. Don't fret about it.
I might have given a little hint there.
Now, these guys are called frets. Can you all say frets? Nice! Now, when you push down on one of these frets, it changes the pitch or the note of the string. So, this is the E string. And then watch as the note changes. Sounds pretty cool, right? Now, do we all remember how to count our frets? You count them starting from up here. So this is fret 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on and so forth. So if I wanted to find fret number 8, let's go figure that out. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There it is, fret number 8. Now let's say if I wanted to play fret number 5. Let's start from the top here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right there. There's your fret number 5. Good job, you guys. So, one more time, this is the guitar. Now let's move on to your next activity.
Hey guys, what's going on? Do you remember what this thing's called? That's right, it's the drum set. Now we're gonna do some ear training. Since you know all about it, you guys have been practicing and learning about the drums for the past few weeks, and now we're gonna do some ear training. What's ear training? It's when you train your ear so you can remember what everything sounds like without even thinking about it. All right, so I'm gonna play each one of these drums. You're gonna close your eyes and you're gonna tell me what drum it is. All right, you ready? Close your eyes, here we go. All right, open your eyes. What drum was that? That's right, it was the snare drum. Very good. All right, close your eyes again. Here we go. Open your eyes. What drum was that? That's right, it was the tom. The what tom, though? There's two toms, the brothers. Very good, it was the rack tom. And why is it a rack tom? Because it sits on a rack. All right. What drum is this? Did you peek? That's right. It's the floor tom. And why is it the floor tom? Because it sits on a floor. I tell you, the guy who came up with this was a genius. All right, let's move on to our cymbals. We have one more drum, but we're gonna get to that at the end. You guys ready? Close your eyes, no peeking. Here we go. What cymbal is that? That's right, it's the hi-hat. It'd make for a very uncomfortable hat, but very fashionable. All right, moving on, here we go. Holy cow, what cymbal was that? One more time, close your eyes, no peeking. Can you take a guess? That's right, it was the crash cymbal, and it's the crash cymbal because it's extra loud. Here we go, moving on, close your eyes. What cymbal is that? That's right, it's the ride cymbal because you cruise on the ride cymbal. Very good. All right, one more drum. Close your eyes. Here we go. What drum is that? One more time. All right, take a guess. That's right, it's the kick drum. Why is it the kick drum? Cause you kick it, dog. Very good. All right, you guys are awesome. We'll see you next week.
Hey, rock stars. We are gonna do a little recap of the la 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 voice. All right, who's ready? Awesome. So I'm gonna need everyone who remembers to just shout it out. What is the first thing we do when we're getting ready to sing? Very good, we warm up. Why is it important to warm up? It's important to warm up so we get our voice loose and awake and ready to do gymnastics. Awesome, if we're gonna do some backflips with our voice, we need to stretch and make sure that we're warm so we don't hurt ourselves. A great way to warm up is doing a little 5-note scale. Like meow, 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 meow. Meow, 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 meow. Can you do it with me? Awesome. 1, 2, 3, 4. Meow, 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 meow. Meow, 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 meow. Very good. 5-note scales and easy singing is a great way to warm up so we don't hurt ourselves. Then once we're a little more warm, we can dive right in to singing the real stuff. Awesome. So I need all of you, when this is over, pick your favorite song and put it on and maybe sing it with it or sing it a cappella. A cappella means no music behind you, but just making music with your voice. Awesome, guys. Keep on singing. You're doing a great job.
Okay, kid rowers, we're about to learn about a new instrument. It might not be super new to you because you've probably seen it in our rehearsal space and you've probably seen me or someone else playing it. Maybe even you've played it. But does anyone know what this is? Nope, it's not an electric guitar. You're close though.
Whoa.
Yeah, it's a bass guitar or a bass. So there's something different about the bass guitar versus an electric guitar that you can see right away.
Let's look up close. Let's count how many strings there are. 1, 2, 3, 4. So how many strings are usually in a regular guitar?
Right, 6. So a bass has 4. Now, here's something very interesting. These letters of these strings are the same as the first 4 string letters of a guitar. You have your E for Eddie, your A for 8, your D for dynamite, and your G for goodbye. but you don't have your B and your E at the end. Goodbye, Eddie. But you have your E, A, D, G. And those are your strings. What else do you notice that's similar with this in a guitar? Yeah, we have frets. We have all the different parts of the neck of the bass has frets on it, and the different frets are gonna sound different. Now, what about these thingamabobbers up here? Are they just like little keys that you turn for fun? No, they're for tuning. You tune the guitar or the bass by turning these different ways. I'm not gonna throw it out of tune. The rule of thumb is you only touch these when you first are gonna pick up your guitar or your bass to play. You don't just play with them just for fun whenever you feel like it. This is the bass. Ta-da!
All right, you guys, now we're gonna learn how to play your song. We're not gonna take it on the bass. So the three notes you're gonna need are E, B, and A. So let's learn how to play those three notes on the bass. First, you're gonna need your open E string. That means you're gonna pluck this E string without pressing down on any of the frets. So here is your E. And then for your B, you're gonna press down on the second fret of this second string right here. And that's your B. And for your A, you're gonna do an open A string. That means you're not pressing down on any frets, and you're gonna pluck this open A string. That's the second string right here. So one more time, this is your E, this is your B, and this is your A. All right, now when you're playing the bass line for We're Not Gonna Take It, you're gonna take every note and you're gonna pluck it two times. So the first half of the chord progression, you're gonna get your E, you pluck that two times, and then you're gonna pluck your B two times. And then you're gonna hop back to E, pluck that two times. And then you're gonna grab your A, you're gonna pluck that two times. So one more time, that's E, B, E, and A. So how about we give that all a try, all right? So, remember, grab onto your basses, grab on real tight, put your fingers on that E string, and remember, you're not pressing down any frets, and we'll go in together on my count. Ready? One, two, here we go. E, and B, and E, and A. Nice job, you guys. All right, let's try that one more time. Here we go. One, two, ready, go. E and B and E and A. Nice job, you guys. So that's the first half of your chord progression. Here is the second half. So you're gonna get your E, you're gonna pluck that two times, E, and then you're gonna go to your B, pluck that two times. And then you're gonna go back to your E, pluck that two times. And then you're gonna go back to your B, pluck that two times. All right, you wanna try that all together? Okay, so one more time. It's E, and then B, then E, then back to B. All right, here we go, let's give that a try. Wait for my count. Here we go, one, two, ready, go. E, then B, and then E, now back to B. Nice job, you guys. All right, let's try that one more time. All right, here we go. One, two, ready, go. E, then B, then E, and then B. Nice job, you guys. All right, now we're gonna get the two parts that we learned. We're gonna mash it all together and it's gonna become our whole part. All right, you guys. So all together, it's gonna be like this. E, then B, then E, and then A. Then E, then B, then E, and B.
Nice job, you guys. All right, so now we're gonna try it all together. And wait for my count in, okay? Here we go, grab onto your bass, boom, and wait for my count in. One, two, here we go. E, then B, then E, then A, then E, then B, out E, back to B. Nice job, you guys. All right, let's try it all together one more time. Here we go, wait for my counting. One, two, here we go. E, then B, then E, now A. E, then B, then E, now back to B. Nice job, you guys! So, with the lyrics of your song, it should sound something like this. We're not gonna take it. No, we ain't gonna take it. We're not gonna take it anymore. We've got the right to choose it. There ain't no way to lose it. This is our life. This is our song. Blah. All right, you guys ready to try that all together with the lyrics of your song? All right, so I did a shortened version that time. So when we perform it this time all together, we're gonna say the chorus two times and then the verse two times. All right, here we go. I'm gonna count us in. One, two, here we go. We're not gonna take it. No, we ain't gonna take it. We're not gonna take it anymore. We're not gonna take it. No, we ain't gonna take it. We're not gonna take it anymore. Here's the verse. Here we go. We've got the right to choose it. There ain't no way to lose it. This is our life. This is our song. One more time, here we go. We've got the right to choose it. There ain't no way to lose it. This is our life. This is our song. Nice job, you guys! And that's how you play We're Not Gonna Take It on the bass.
All right, let's do one of my favorite songs. It's the Avocado song. So first, we're gonna use dynamics for doing this. So that means we're gonna start off soft and then we're gonna get louder and louder as it goes. And we're gonna also use our stage presence to show our body. So we're gonna start by picking avocados. And then at the end when we go guacamole, guac, guacamole, we're gonna go nuts, okay? Maybe we should add nuts to the song. All right, you ready? First, you. Slice avocados, then you mash avocados, mash avocados, then you guacamole, guacamole, serious face. It's hard to have a serious face with pink hair. Next up, we are gonna go bananas. So first, we slice bananas, then we mash bananas, then we go bananas, go bananas, serious face. Not serious enough. Much better. Next up, we're gonna sauce some apples. How do you sauce some apples? First, you pick the apples, pick the apples, then you pick the apples, pick the apples, Then you slice the apples, slice, slice the apples. Then you slice the apples, slice, slice the apples. Then you mash the apples, mash, mash the apples. Then you mash the apples, mash, mash the apples. Then you sauce the apples, sauce, sauce the apples. Apple sauce the apples, sauce, sauce the apples. Cherry sauce. Next up, we need something to wash this all down with. I prefer a nice cold glass of lemonade. So to make lemonade, first you need some sugar. Okay, and a little water. Then you pick the lemons, pick the lemons. Then you pick the lemons, pick the lemons. Then you slice the lemons, slice, slice the lemons. Then you slice the lemons, slice, slice the lemons. Then you squeeze the lemons, squeeze, squeeze the lemons. Then you squeeze the lemons, squeeze, squeeze the lemons. Then you aid the lemons, lemonade, aid the lemons. Then you aid the lemons, lemonade the lemons. Then you have yourself a whole meal. Not an eel, a meal. So you get the guacamole, whoop, and the mashed up bananas, whoop, and some applesauce, whoop, and you eat it. I need something to drink. Lemonade. And there you have it. Hello up there from down here. It's time to be on our bellies. Now, if you are a baby, tummy time is one of the best times of the day. And you can lay your baby on their tummy and help them with moving their hands to the different beat of the song so they can kind of start getting rhythm inside their body and listen to the sound of the song and the lyrics of the song and start getting that in their body. Now, if you're not a baby, then get out of here. Just kidding. If you're not a baby, then you can put yourself on your belly. And that's the best way to do the hammer song, if you ask me, which you did. Well, you didn't, but you did, so. All right, first we gotta get a hammer out. You ready? I'm gonna move back a little so you can see my hammers. Ready? And I'm gonna turn sideways so you can see all my hammers. You ready? One, two, three. Now we hammer with one hammer, one hammer, one hammer. Now we hammer with one hammer all day long. It's after one, two. Now we hammer with two hammers, two hammers, two hammers. Now we hammer with two hammers all day long. What's after two? Right, three. Boing. And if you look really closely, you can see I have donuts on my socks. Do you like donuts? Good. Then this sock's for you. One, two, three. Now we hammer with three hammers, three hammers, three hammers. Now we hammer with three hammers all day long. You're right, four. I didn't even have to ask. Very good. Ready? Now we hammer with four hammers, four hammers, four hammers. Now we hammer with four hammers all day long. What's after four? Right. You just had a birthday, that's how you know. Now you're five. All right, ready for the next one? We have to do a little headbanging. You up for some headbanging? Well, you came to the right place. This is Kid Row after all. Ready? One, two, three, four. Now we hammer with five hammers, five hammers, five hammers. Now we hammer with five hammers all day long. Whew. I'm so tired, but wait. We still have one more song. I mean, one more hammer. Ready? Blech. It matches my hair. It's the same color, right? Now we hammer with six hammers, six hammers, six hammers. Now we hammer with six hammers all day long. Blech. Blech. We did it, good job. Good hammer song today, guys. Whew.
All right, you guys, you ready to jam out to your song? Okay, so can you say, we're the Backflips? And this is, we're not gonna take it. Nice, now can you all say, hit it, drummer?
great jamming with you.
All right. We're going to play a little game of freeze dance. This is a freeze dance from the 2000s. So when I stop the music, you stop dancing. Here we go. Let's try this out. I'm going to fight them all. A seven nation army couldn't hold me back. Did everybody stop? Everybody stop dancing? All right, let's keep going. They're going to rip it off. Taking their time right behind my back. And I'm talking. Who froze? Here you go. Can do myself at night because I can't forget. Back and forth through my mind behind a sick. Oh. I hope you paused. And a message coming from my eyes says, leave it alone. I definitely moved that time. I'm out. Who's gonna keep going? That was a short one. Just seeing if you're on your toes. Don't wanna hear. All right, I'm making it easy because I'm stopping it on the beat. Let's see what happens if I don't stop the next one on the beat. Every single one's got a story to tell. Everyone knows about it. Did you stop? I hope you stopped. Like my way, I'm gonna serve it to you. And that ain't what you want to hear, but that's what I'll do. I tricked you. I didn't stop it. Keep dancing. And the feeling coming from my bones says find a home. We're getting close to the end here. I want to make sure that we're all still dancing here. Are we freezing? All right, we're getting close to the end here. All right, I hope you paused. All right, everybody, so I'm gonna be DJing this Friday at 6 p.m. on the Kid Row Instagram. We're gonna be doing all these hits from the 2000s, the early 2000s, all right? So if you're around Friday, 6 p.m., come tune in. DJ Ian Sloan, rock and roll, Kid Row. I hope you caught that last pause.
Okay, guys, class is almost over, but before it is, there is one thing that I really wanted to teach you guys, and that is practice. Practicing your instruments and your songs are very, very important. Practicing is something that you do when you're learning something new so that you can get good at it. And so, like, for example, if I was learning how to ride a bicycle, I don't just jump on a bicycle and start riding because I don't know how yet. So I get on and I learn about the pedals and I start having someone tell me different things about it that can help. And I work on my balance and I kind of ride my bike a little every day. And then eventually I'm really riding my bike and I know how to do it and I don't even need practice anymore. I just can do it. So the same thing with your songs. I want you guys to listen to your songs over and over and over again so that it gets so in your body and in your brain that it becomes easy to remember. One of the things you can do while you're listening to the song is count the beats. And that way you can, like, in 1, 2, 3, 4, you can kind of get that into your body and that into your system, so that when you go to play your instrument or sing or do whatever you're going to be doing in the band, you're ready and it's already in your body, and then you can focus on what you need to do. Like, for example, if you're the singer, you can focus on the lyrics because you already have the beat and the rhythm going in your body and you already know what's coming next. And then you can also practice your different stage presence stuff with practicing. So once it's in your body and then you can start, you know what notes to play and stuff, but then you start working on how you're moving your body on stage and all that. So I want you guys to practice, practice, practice. It's the most important thing. Every single band ever in the world has always had to practice over and over and over again. The Beatles were not good as musicians until they practiced like a million times, and then they got really good. And they started in their garage. Garage band, the most original garage band of all time. All right, guys, so what are you gonna do? No, practice!
Hey, Backflip, who came to rock? Yeah, we did! 1, 2, 3, 4, who came to rock today? Rock today, rock today. Who came to rock today? We all came to rock. Who came to rock today? Rock today, rock today.
We'll see you next week. Bye.
I'll see you next week.
What's up, party animals? It's your boy Bear here at the Kid Row headquarters. I had so much fun rocking out with you guys today and learning all about the bass. Hey, quick question. How many strings are on the bass? You guessed it, 4. What about the guitar? How many strings are on that? Nailed it. 6. Good job, you guys. All right, now it's time to have some fun and get super creative. Let's draw your bases. Don't forget to tune in to Instagram Live this Friday, 6 p.m. DJ Ian Sloan is going to be playing all of our hits from the early 2000s. So bust out those Canadian tuxedos and we'll see you there. All right, guys, rock and roll. See you next week.